Yeah, it's frustrating because we were all raving about our pitching depth heading into 2021, and then now people are like, "Oh my God, we need Marcus Stroman, we need more pitching." I'm like, you know, Mora Hone's going to be back post All-Star break. I mean, I really don't think this team needs as much starting pitching as everyone's saying. I really think
We don't know about Chris Paddock's status and all that, but I want to go back to the beginning of 2021 and all that. I bought in too, right? How could you not? But I also wrote a few articles about this team's going to be hurting for innings. That's part of why there was no doubt in my mind they were making an addition at the trade deadline. But even with all these guys, I can go back and think of these charts that I made and all this, adding up the innings. I mean, all these guys, Blake Snell had, you know, whatever. Let's say he was Cy Young form all season. He still hadn't gone more than 7 1/3 innings in his career.
Ever.
So Joe Musgrove, who ended up being, to me, clearly their best pitcher, if you factor in not only his performance, but consistency and the whole year. Exactly. That guy threw, like, was it 39 innings last year? He'd only gone above 130 once, I think. There was going to be Adrian Morahone, even if he'd stayed healthy, wasn't going to give you 150. There were a lot of innings that needed to be filled, and they filled them with the bullpen early on, and it ended up hurting them at the end. So there was all this depth, but then Michelle Baez goes down. You go back, you wanted organizational depth. Jacob Nix goes down. He was going to be in Triple A and be a guy. Matt Strom, who was a 2 or 3 inning guy in the bullpen, and go back and look at what he's done. He did not pitch for them this year. So that's why it was weird to me that there was no. And by the way, they also expected this guy, Mackenzie Gore, to be up. So they're just like, there were going to be problems, or there was going to be a challenge. And with all those injuries, it turned into a problem.
Another guy that we loved, Nelson Lamet. What's his status? A lot of people in my chat and were like, God damn it, he should have went under the knife again. He should have went under the knife. Look at guys like Nathan Eovaldi coming back from a second Tommy John being their wild card starter, Mike Clevenger. What are they going to do with him? Because in my opinion, they're telling us we want him to be a starter. I think it's over. I think those days are over. And of Denelson throwing 6 innings of 100 mile per hour with that 91 mile per hour devastating slider. I think the best case scenario is you try and convert him into a closer, maybe, because he has, you know, that amazing stuff. What are you hearing about what they're going to do with Lamet? Because man, in that COVID year, I mean, his slider was almost as devastating as Tyson Ross's 5 years ago. It was unbelievable.
But again, it was all part of the facade of, and I'm a huge Denelson Lamet talent guy.
60 game season.
And I think he's a great guy. It was all part of the facade of the 60 game season.
Yeah.
Eric Hosmer couldn't, you know, was either going to be hot or cold, and he turned out to be hot. Sure. Will Myers was going to be hot or cold. He turned out to be hot. No one had to go longer than 60 games. Denelson Lamet, you know, ended the season on the IL and all that. What I'm hearing, I believe, is code for that they expect him to be a reliever. They will give him, this is the proverbial, I believe, provided that he's healthy, the proverbial, we're going to give him a chance to start, right? How many guys? There'll be 10 guys competing for a spot in spring training, and then you'll see them drop off, and some of them will go to the bullpen, some of them will go to AAA. I think you're right. I think that they think that this guy has a real future in the bullpen, because when I say code, what you're hearing is you can't count on him as a starter. You would love to count on him as a starter, but if you're the team and you're in any way responsible, and no matter what you think of the Padres, they're not that dumb, you cannot be counting on Denelson Lamet as a starter. And that's like heartbreaking, because you are absolutely correct. Heck, even in 2019, when he was working his way back, spring training of 2018, this guy was like ace material.
Unreal.
And has the mentality for it too. So now, second Tommy John, who is it? There's another one besides Eovaldi who has come, that has already come back and has performed really well. But
anyone in the chat,
Jameson, yes, that's the two guys. Okay. Other than that, the history of a second Tommy John, not good. Now, Tommy John, the surgery and the prehab and the rehab is constantly advancing. So maybe it's going to become a regular thing that after your second Tommy John, you're as good as after your first, and you're as good as before you went under the knife. Heck, maybe even better. That's how good it's getting and how quickly it's advancing. But as of right now, man, it is not a given that you want to go under. I mean, and that's another thing. Mike Clevenger, And that's part of what kind of stabs you in the heart about the whole Cal Quantrill. And I happen to be a big Josh Naylor guy. But that kind of get like, oh, if Mike Clevenger does not come back and pitch like he did from whatever it was, 16 to 20. Because he's coming back from a second Tommy John at 30 years old. He may very well.